What's going on, Feed the Beasters? JD here with the next episode of JD Plays Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. Episode 17, I believe. And today, it's time to step back into the world of magic a little bit. So on our to-do list, after all the machinery we've been doing, I've lined up some stuff to do in Botania, Thaumcraft, and Witchery. We may run out of time before we finish it all, but we're going to do our best to get it all knocked out. So let's start off with the Botania stuff, and let's head downstairs. So down here, you can see, as usual, my Ender Lily stockpile is growing. That's good. I've got a bunch of the living rock being crafted up, and I've got three full pools of mana. I've moved my Botania setup over, and I've got the auto fuel burning system going right now. And I've got this set up where I can actually step back here and turn this off, but you see how I keep dragging everything around with me, all the living rock, all of the blaze rods that I want to use for fuel here. That's not always a good thing. I don't always want my ring of magnetization working like that, because sometimes it's going to pick up things that I don't want, or, you know, even things that, for example, throwing down Certus Quartz and stuff, and I want them not to be picked up by it. The game does a good job of not allowing that to happen in most cases, but there are scenarios where something might drop that you do not want it to pick up. So we want to do something about that, and that's part of the flowers that we can make in Botania. Lost my train of thought there. The Solegnolia gives us that, and that's one of the things we're going to make. But the first thing I want to make is I want to make a mana distributor. So like I said, we've got three full pools of mana right here. And somewhere I've got a wand. And basically what I've done is I had originally six of these Endo Flames. I've now got 12 of them running. I've got two mana spreaders that are firing into these individual mana pools. And I've got one full pool. Originally I had both of them firing directly into this pool. Now they're firing into these two. Firing into the front pool, they can eliminate their mana bar, you know, the stock that they hold locally, a lot quicker than they can to these. So one of the things that would be nice is if we could have an assortment of mana pools and fill them up all, you know, independent at the same time, keep the same fill level. And Botania does that via the mana distributor. So we just need a couple of mana steel ingots, which I happen to have some upstairs. I meant to grab them before I came down, but as usual, I'm distracted because it's late and I've been doing a lot of stuff today. So let's grab a couple of mana steel ingots. I grabbed 24, and that's okay. I also moved all my berry bushes out of this corner. They're now back here in the sealed up room where I can go use them as I need them. Alright, so I have a crafting table right over here. And I've got another recipe in here right now called redstone root. And we're going to actually make some of this. This is also from Botania. And it's just grass clippings, the tall grass that you can cut from the ground using a set of shears and some redstone. So we're going to make some of that right quick. We'll set it aside for now. We're going to be using that shortly. And let's drop that in. And then what did I do with that living stone I just had? Did I put it in here? Or did I put it in here? Here's some. All right, so let's put bottom, top, and that will give us a mana distributor. Now what a mana distributor does, if we put it right here in the center, we can set the mana spreaders to target the distributor. And the distributor now will put mana into each pool evenly instead of having to focus on a single pool and readjust them. So I can put pools on each of the facing plates of the distributor and it will feed mana to it. I don't know if that's ever been modified to get these corners. I usually just do three or four pools and we call it good. Okay? So that's the mana distributor. The next thing that I want to make is big in terms of the rest of the crafting we're going to be doing from Botania and from things that depend on Botania. And that is the Runic Alter. And that's this right here. A Runic Alter takes an Ender Pearl and some Living Rock. Well, I don't know where we're going to get an Ender Pearl. Snicker. So let's grab one of those and put the seed back down. Pick this bad mamma jamma up and we will throw it directly into the poolest of them all. Boom, there's that. Step back over here. Put this down. Living rock. There's our runic altar. Now, a runic altar, we're just going to put it down right here. And we use this to actually craft a lot of different runes. So for example, right here, if we look at the Rune of Water, on this Runic Altar, we would place 3 Mana Steel Ingots, 1 Water Shard, 1 Fishing Rod, 1 Sugar Cane, some Bone Meal, and a little bit of mana, and we would get back 3 Runes of Water. And that's going to come into play more later. We're not going to use it right away. But we've got that done. That's ready for the next step. Alright, last thing that I want to make right now in Botania is this Solegnolia. And that red root that we made earlier, redstone root, this is where we're going to actually make use of it. So let's get some brown petals. And I should have a bucket somewhere. Right here. Put some of these tools away for the moment. There we go. Okay, brown petals, blue petals, red petals. We're going to need some mana powder. Now, if you don't remember how mana powder is made, it's very simple. You just drop any, there's all kinds of dust, so redstone, glowstone, they all work. Drop it right in there and you'll get back mana powder, okay? So I've got 64, but I'm just going to keep it right here along with some seeds. And we're going to get a single seed. Actually, we're going to need 2. And we'll need another mana powder as well. All right. So grab us a bucket of water. Put it in here. Let's throw in 2 of these. 1 of these. 1 of these. 1 of these. And I'm going to need another one of those. And it tells you that it's ready to go right now. So fire off a regular seed and we'll get back our Solegnolia. Now, I want to make another one of these. Just why not? So, easy way to do that is have an empty hand, right click, and it will put the recipe back in there. And then all we gotta do is throw in this bad mamma jamma. And this one happened to not take mana powder, so we can save that for later usage. So we've got these 2 Solegnolias. Now, if we turn this on, I'm gonna start scooping up, even at this distance, for all the way from here, I'm gonna start scooping up everything this thing drops. And that kinda sucks. And when I get the Ring of Greater Magnetization, that effect is going to be even worse. And that's where these flowers come into play. So I'm going to put one, let's say, here, and the other here for now. Just for fun. And we're going to turn that on. And now, the Ring of Magnetization no longer has any effect. I can stand as close to these as I want. As long as I'm within the range of these flowers, my ring will no longer drag items to me. And that's very nice. It's a very useful flower. And with that, I'm kind of done with Botania for the moment. Now, we're going to be using things from Botania, but we're done down here. And I've got a bunch of these I'm going to stick back in there. And yeah, 7,200 blaze rods left and a bunch of full pools of mana. It's nice. All right, I'm going to drop off my Botania stick for a little bit because I don't need that for the moment. And we're going to head upstairs now. So let's update the to-do list. Now, I also have this auto work bench. Now, what did I do with that? I put it somewhere. Maybe it's upstairs. Let's go take a look upstairs. I made this messing around just to kind of have something to do some cheap auto crafting for me. And I'm not going to really go into too many details. It's a simple crafting table that will craft things for you. So for example, we put it down here and we have to give it a recipe. So do I have right here. If I take out of this box my cobblestone and I set up a recipe in here, it knows, okay, anytime I have enough cobblestone, I want to craft this compressed cobble. So if I put that in here, it's gonna start crafting it. It takes no power, it requires no energy to run, it is kind of slow, but it does the job for free. So you can use these auto workbenches to automate crafting some, you know, anything you're going to use repetitively early on, and you can pump items in and pull items out of it. It's very cheap to make, taking a crafting table and 2 stone gears. So if you're looking for an early game, real cheap form of auto crafting, the auto workbench might do it for you, okay? All right. So from there, we're ready to talk about some Thaumcraft stuff. And in Thaumcraft, we need to make a couple of things. We need to make an Arcane Alembic and some Arcane Stone blocks. an alchemical furnace, and a deconstruction table. Those are what are on the list for me today. Now, I want to start off by making some of this living rock, or arcane rock, I'm sorry. And for this, you're going to need stone, living rock, some type of shard. We're going to use order shards, and then it's going to require some form of essence. To get the essence, this is where your wand comes into play. And I had to go around and find a bunch of nodes and drain essence from the nodes to fill my wand up. So right now, this is what I've got. Well, I also happen to have killed a couple of Crimson Cultists. And sometimes their gear can cut down on your cost. So let's see if it does. So let's see. Let's put this on. Put this on. And let's go back. 110% viz cost. Uh-oh. It didn't do anything. Actually, I don't honestly remember what all things these Crimson Cult Greaves and stuff do, but I know that there is a set of armor from the Crimson Cultists that affect Thaumcraft, so I'll have to dig more into that. Thaumcraft and Witchery and Botania are probably my weakest mods, so bear with me if I'm, you know, make a lot of mistakes. It's part of the fun. We're going to take our wand, we're going to stick it in the table. There we go. It is now draining the essence that it needs from the wand to craft the arcane blocks. And we don't want it to drain too much. So I'm not going to make all of these right off. I want to make sure that we get some of these other recipes that we need done first. And then we'll come back and make additionals if we need them. Now, one of the things that I want to get made right away is this deconstruction table. And somewhere I have a Thaumonomicon. I probably put it away. Nope, here it is. And the deconstruction table is pretty important to me because it allows us to recover essence. For research and things like that. And by the way, I've done a lot of research in my Thaum book since the last time you saw me. Almost all everything in the basic information tab has been researched. Most of my Thaumaturgy tab has been researched. I've got the excavation focus and a wand of equal trade focus. I've done some heavy researching into alchemy. So you're going to want to do this at your own speed. Researching is pretty simple and pretty straightforward. So I'm not really going to ever show that on camera, but know that I have been steadily unlocking this stuff, and I'll continue to do so. So back up here in basic information, we have a deconstruction table. And to craft a deconstruction table, we need a mana steel pickaxe, a mana steel axe, a table, and a thaumometer. Now, we've already got a thaumometer, and we've made the other pieces in the past. Let's see, where's all my great wood at? Here's some. Let's make another table. If I can remember how to make the table. I don't know why I can never remember this dang recipe. But I'm horrible about it. Right here, table. Okay, that's it. Alright, so we're going to grab this. And then the other item that we needed for this was these mana steel items. And it's going to take 20 perditio to do this. Okay? So let's go ahead. Does that require a... Yeah, arcane workbench. Okay. So let's stick the thaumometer in. Let's stick the table in. And let's make these mana steel items. Now, a mana steel axe is simply living wood with mana steel ingots and pickaxe, shovel, sword. You get the idea behind it. It's pretty simple. We're going to need to go make both of these. I believe all my living wood is downstairs real quick. So let's run down here. Right there some. No. And we'll just make some twigs. And we throw this in here. And we can go doot, doot, doot. And there's our axe. And doot, doot, doot. And there's our pick. Okay. I'm going to leave this twig down here. And we're going to run back up. All right. So over on the table, our wand is still in. And our wand has 25 perditio in it. And we may have to go refill that after this. So, right there, that gives us our deconstruction table. Now, I don't remember what the best thing to put in this is anymore, but the deconstruction table allows you to take things like, let's use, I don't know, bookshelf. And come over here and we throw that bookshelf in there and it will break it down for us and it will give us some ignis, some fire. So if you ever run out of materials in here to research, you can take common items, craft them, throw them into the deconstruction table, and get back more essence to work with. Alright. So, that gives us some arcane stone. That gives us a deconstruction table. Let's update the to-do list real quick. Alright, the next thing we want to work on is the alembic. The alembic is not too difficult. It takes some iron ingots, some gold, a viz filter, which we've never made, and then it's going to take some air and some aqua. The viz filter is simply silverwood planks and gold ingots. Now, the question is where is my silverwood? Because I have some. I just don't know what I've done with it. It's very possible that it's also downstairs. So let's go down there and look real quick. It would help if I would remember to move these things upstairs, but I'm going to need them, wouldn't it? No. Alright, what did I do with that silverwood? Alright, before we go marching back upstairs, I don't have any planks. But I've got these somewhere. Right there. I know I've got more than that actually as well, but that'll work for now. So let's run back up top. You see the creeper looking at me? He's like, hey, can I come play with you? And I'm like, nope. No, you may not, Mr. Creeper. Alright, we're going to need our sawmill. And right now, our sawmill is frankly non-operational. Because it's sitting right here. But we can pop it off. And run right around this little corner. And here we have a nice little set of power conduits that we made recently, remember? So if I pop this on here, I can throw this silverwood in here. It's powered up, it's ready to go, and it's going to shoot out some silverwood planks. And then we needed some gold. A couple of gold here. We need three of them. Yep. And we needed some iron and a bucket. Alright. There's a bucket. Alright, let's get this done. Step over here. Take our silverwood plank, and there's our viz filter. It's going to cost some ordo and some aqua. Pop that back in. Put one of these down. Come around. Something like that, I think. And like this. And there we go. Air and aqua again, and we get our arcane alembic. Alright, now this arcane alembic is used in Thaumcraft, but we're not going to use it right now. We'll come back to what this actually does later. Right now we're going to be using this as a component. The next thing we need to make is our alchemical furnace. And that's this bad mamma jamma. This is why we needed the arcane blocks. And why we're also going to need a crucible. Now I should still have some crucibles laying around. Right here's one. And if I take this and throw it down and pull my wand out, you're a wizard, Harry. Put my wand back. Okay, and I should have a pickaxe somewhere. Right there is fine. Okay, and then we're going to need to go grab a furnace. Should have one of those in here. There we go. Run back as fast as we can. And it should go furnace, crucible, arcane stone. And that gives us an alchemical furnace. Like I said, this also is used in Thaumcraft, just like the alembic, but we're going to be using it as a component in another recipe at the moment. So let's go ahead and knock out. We're done with dealing with Thaumcraft for the moment. And we're actually ready to start Witchery. Now, Witchery is kind of complex to start, and it's very different, and it will give you a headache if you have no idea how to start it. If you've never messed with Witchery, I advise you to open your inventory screen by pressing E. And click on guide. And right here is Witchery, and it will tell you how to start. Okay? I'm going to show you a bit of how to start right now. And most of the stuff that we're going to do will end up getting moved somewhere else later. We're just going to do it down here for this time. Now, you're going to need to start off with one of these water artichokes. And I have not bred this or done anything with it. I've just gotten it grown up and ready to do the demonstration I'm about to do for you guys. Okay? So, you're going to need... take this water artichoke, and if you combine it, if you breed it through Agricraft with a wheat seed, and water artichokes are pretty easy to find, by the way, breed it with a wheat seed, and you'll end up with a mandrake root. And if you take that mandrake root and breed it with the artichoke, you will end up with belladonna seeds. And then the last piece that you need is going to be a needle from some snowbells. And snowbell seeds, I believe, let's look... been a long time since I've bred those. Snowbell comes from breeding belladonna and mandrake. So you can interbreed, as soon as you get a water choke, you can build your water artichoke. You can build yourself up to the rest of these seeds. I happen to have been, you know, kind of waiting for this, so I was prepared. So we're going to take these, and we're going to bring it right over here. We're going to get rid of this fancy smancy stick. Put in our mandrake, belladonna, icy thorns, and you can hear these spiders just dying right now. That's because they're stuck on top of these bushes in here dying. I can actually break this glass and collect the loot from this. It's kind of funny. Anyway, so what we are working on right now is the first quote-unquote machine for witchery, and it is the Witch's Cauldron. Or just Cauldron, I don't remember which. There you go, Witch's Cauldron. Alright. Well, one of these is the Witch's Cauldron. I don't remember. So, what we have to make to get a Witch's Cauldron is we have to take a regular cauldron and apply anointing paste to it. And to make anointing paste, we need a bottle of water and some mystical cyan petals. My goodness, guys. Chill out. Alright, so let's go upstairs and get those other pieces that we need real quick. So we're going to need a bottle of water. Well, I've got jars right here. We just need one. And we'll just scoop us some water right there. Cyan petals we'll get from downstairs. But then we'll also need this cauldron. Oh, it's not in there. I moved them. Cauldron right here. Bam. Alright. So let's jump back down. And I'm going to eventually make it much easier for me to go up and down these stairs. Promise. Alright, so let's put this in the middle. And then we need those blue cyan petals. Now, where am I going to get those? Those should probably come from my flower pouch. Which should be right there. So if we open this up. Cyan blue flower right there. We need 4 petals. We get 2 per plant. Run those around, and it goes mandrake, belladonna, anointing paste. Okay, now if we take these, and I think we place this down, if I remember right. Like I said, it's been a long time since I've done this, so it's entirely possible I'm about to screw this up. There we go. We've now got a witch's cauldron. Alright, now once we have the witch's cauldron, We'll want to get the witch's oven. Okay? Now, the witch's oven takes iron bars, mana steel ingots, arcane stone blocks, and fire crystals. So, as you can see, to get into witchery, you need to already be established in Botania, and you need to already be established in Thaum. So, some of this stuff we have up top, because we're going to need to go get some fire crystals, and we're going to need to get some iron bars. Now, I've got iron bars in one of these crafting stations somewhere. Question is, which one? Or I did. I may have gotten rid of them all. Iron bars right here. Alright, so this one we're actually going to try to craft from right here if we can. So iron bars, alembic, a couple of mana steel ingots, We're going to need to make some more arcane stone. So if you remember the recipe, it was four of these guys. And four of these guys. With a shard of some kind in the center. So let's drop that in there. And there we go. We get eight more arcane stone now. The fire crystal is pretty simple as well. You're just going to need some fire shards. Six of them. So we'll run those up and over like so, and that'll give us our fire crystal. So put that there. Fire crystal, and that gives us our witch's oven. Now the witch's oven, the way it operates, you're going to want to add this fume funnel to it. And I can't remember how many you can add. I think you can add two or three or something like that. You'll want to look it up. But this improves the operational output of the oven. And it may say something about that in the guide. Let me check. So we'll need the witch's oven, and you'll need the witch's oven to cook up our basic ingredients for Mutandis. And we've already done this step because, well, we just did it. Okay, so I was told by Drago, who's my, you know, resident magic expert, two is the most you can have. So you'll want to make two of these fumes. I'm not going to make them yet. Well, should I? I guess we'll make them. Why not? Do I have plates? I do. How are we at on recording time here? Let's take a look at that. We're at 26 minutes. Yeah, we'll make them. Why not? All right, we're going to need to make some serious buckets here. All right. So we're going to take bucket, 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 bucket. Let's get two buckets of lava at the same time. That way we don't have to come back and do this. Lava, lava. Alright, and then we're going to want some glowstone, some blocks of iron, and some more iron bars. Okay, that's pretty simple. So two of these, a good amount of iron ingots, which we'll put in here and make blocks out of. Bam. And the glowstone we can get from right here. So there we go. We got two fume funnels coming right up. And those will go onto our arcane alembics. Onto our witch's oven. So let's go back downstairs, over by our cauldron and where we're operating. Like I said, this is eventually going to be moved. So let's just put this right here for now. And you'll take your fume funnels and put them directly on the top of the oven. Uh-oh, what? That's weird looking. I don't know if that's a bug or what's going on with that, but I don't think it's supposed to look like that. I thought it was supposed to. I don't know. Maybe that is how it's supposed to look. It's been a long time since I've done this. There we go. Set it to the side. Now we've got our two fume funnels on there. All right. Now, if you were reading along in the guide, you notice that it said, cook up some basic ingredients for our Mutandis. Okay, let's look at Mutandis right quick. Now, I've already got some Mutandis. I found it out in the wild. So, Mutandis takes Mandrake Root, Exhale of Horned One, and an egg. How do we get this Exhale of Horned One? Well, for this, you're going to need to cook an oak sapling in this witch's oven, and that's going to give you some wood ash. Okay, so we got some oak saplings somewhere, I'm sure. Here's some. Let's take these. Let's throw them in here. We've got some stuff that's burnable, right? Let's take this, throw it in there. All right, we're cooking. And I'm actually just going to grab a stack of this and throw it in here to cook. Alright, we got some ash. Alright. We don't have the byproduct yet. That's what we're waiting on. Now, we actually need this ash as well, because the ash is used to make, I think it's lime. Bone meal. Refined wood ash. Thought there was a way to get lime out of it somehow. I'll look at it in a minute. It might be the Rowan wood. Or Rowan ash or whatever. Come on, baby. Give me that exhale of horned one. You can do this. Oh, I gotta have a clay jar in there. I'm dumb. Clay jar. We're gonna need a clay jar. So a clay jar is just a soft clay jar, so we'll just need to get a bit of clay real quick. That was not intelligent of me. Back here, our sludge boiler is still running, and guess what? It produces clay. And we're actually gonna need a few of these clay jars, so let's just take a stack of that clay with us. Run back. Okay. There's some clay jars. Alright, we need to fire those clay jars. I don't think I have any furnaces down here. Do I? Nope. Do I have... Yeah, I do right here. And we got a furnace down here now. Alright. Oh, I do have a furnace. It's around the corner down there. I forgot about that one. And let's throw this in here. And let's grab one of those. And there we go. We're cooking those up. As soon as we get one, we'll throw it in there. Alright, there we go. So, put our clay jar in. Now we get our exhale of horned one. Okay, cool. So, the other ingredients that we need for Mutandis were mandrake root and an egg. Do I have an egg? That is the question. Because I have not been raising chickens like I usually do. So having an egg might actually end up being an issue at the moment for me. Let's see if we have an egg around this base. Apparently we do somewhere. We're looking for the little flecks and specks, and there it is. Eggs. Yay, eggs. I just threw something away that I needed, and I don't know what it was. There it is, my pickaxe. I would have been looking for that for an hour later if I hadn't found that just now. Okay, let's run back down. Man, I really do need to make a, the via tube you were talking about the other day, Drago. Mandrake root, that's the other thing that I need. And I should have a watering can right here. Let's water up our mandrake. Now, I don't have the sprinkler going right here, or this stuff would grow a lot faster. It's mature. Let's pick it. What do I want to throw away? Nothing. There we go. All right. So, for Mutandis, we need a cauldron with eggs, horned one, and mandrake root. We have all that. But, right here. Here's the trick. If you don't have flint and steel, which we do, how do you light it? Neither won't work, so you can use a fire charge if you wanted to. We're going to use flint and steel because I actually have one. Now, where that is a good question, but I do have one. I've also got some netherrack to put under it to let it just burn. So netherrack should be here. So if you don't happen to have flint and steel, which, depending on how you're playing, if you're going straight for magic, that's entirely believable. you can use a fire charge from Thaumcraft to get it going on. Now, where is my flint and steel is the question, because I know I have one. If I don't have one, guess what? I'm about to make one. Because, yeah, I'm not making a fire charge. I've got steel right here. Flint and steel. Winning. Run down. Do I have a bucket? bed. I'm gonna need a bucket. I don't really remember whether you're supposed to do this, but I think you are. And I think so, I'm gonna do it. Alright, let's pick those up. Put the nether rack down right there. Make it look pretty again. Light the fire. Okay. With your now lit cauldron, you can make the mutandis. Okay. So we want to take and put in a egg. I don't remember how to do this part. This part always messes me up. There's a way to interact with this and I don't know it. There's that. There's that. And there's that. And voila. We has witchery doing something, I think. Mutandis, we win. So why did we make Mutandis? Well, Mutandis, if you keep reading the guide, is what we're going to use on plant life to change it to a Rowan sapling. So Rowan, right here, recipe. Well, it doesn't tell me the recipe. It should, but it doesn't. So I believe we just need to get a simple, get off me, oak sapling to do this with. Which I cooked all my oak saplings just now. Not all of them, but some of them. So I think we could take these and plant them here. Do we have to do this or do we have to power proof them? I don't remember. There we go. That's acacia. We're going to need acacia as well. Hawthorn, we're gonna need hawthorn as well. Mushroom, that's no good. Jungle, that's cool. I'll take jungle. So as you can see, Mutandis is nice for mutating saplings. There's an alder. And not a, we did not want a lily pad. Now I think I've got some more Mutandis upstairs, so I'm gonna go grab it rather than making more right now. Did I just hear an arrow get shot at me? I think I did. I thought I had Mutandis up here. Maybe I don't. Yeah, right there. We got four more. And you can find Mutandis out in the world. So keep in mind, anything that you know that you've already found, you can skip the step that you saw me do that you're like, hey, I've already got that. Cool. Congratulations. Don't worry about that step. Hawthorn. Glintweed. Spanish moss. Okay. We're going to pick up these saplings, acacia. And now I'm going to be stuck making more mutandis to get up to the Rowan. Alright, let's look at our to-do list right now. Where are we at? So we've done starting seeds, we've done witch's cauldron, we've done the witch's oven. All that's left is the distillery on this list. So let's see, what does it take to make a distillery? Here's a distillery. To make a distillery, you're going to need Odor of Purity, Whiff of Magic, the Arcane Alembic, a Tuned Stone, which is a mana diamond with Whiff of Magic and a lava bucket, some gold ingots. Odor of Purity takes hawthorn saplings being cooked to get wood ash, and it will produce Odor of Purity. Whiff of Magic takes Rowan. So until I get that Rowan, I'm kind of bottlenecked. So I'm going to, let's take a look. Where are we at on the recording right now? I'm going to pause the recording and I'll come back as soon as we get this Rowan sapling knocked out. Alright, and we are back with a Rowan sapling. So, it's good that we've got the saplings. You saw that we're obviously going to need a few of these. We're going to need the hawthorn, we're going to need the Rowan. I also kind of hinted that we were going to need a few of the others. They're just going to come in handy. The Alder's one. So what we need to do is we want to take these, and we're probably going to want to grow them somewhere where we can, you know, replicate these trees without having to go through and do Mutandis every single time. So somewheres right in one of these chests, I have fertilizer right here. Let's take these guys outside. It is nighttime, so let's sleep and bag it up right quick. And we'll just drop down here. Plant us a Rowan tree right here. Boom. Rowan's got some cool looking logs. Let's hack her down. Plenty of Rowan saplings now, and we'll leave one out here for future use. We know we're going to need a Hawthorn tree. Let's get this one up. That's what your Hawthorns look like. They too have some pretty amazing logs. And uh-oh, we didn't get back one that time. That kind of sucks. So let's see if we can Mutandis this. Where did my Mutandis go? Right there. We're going to see if we can get us another Hawthorn here. There's a dark oak, poppy, acacia, moss, jungle, acacia, spruce. It did me dirty. All right, going to go back inside, try this again. I thought I'd gotten more than one Hawthorn, but apparently not. And see, there's mobs still spawning here. I don't understand how mobs are continuing to spawn here. The base is completely lit up. It makes no sense. Water in the cauldron. And this is, I think my third or fourth batch of this stuff at this point. Okay, so mandrake, horned one, egg, wave of the mutandis. Okay. Saplings. Please. Not yet. There we go. All right, we're going to go ahead and use this Hawthorn. I'll make another Hawthorn for my own use later because I want to move forward with this. All right. Yeah, that's what I'll do later, Drago. So we've got our Hawthorn, and we wanted to make a distillery, right? Now, there are a few things that go with this, but let's go ahead and keep in mind, you may not get it on your first try, so we may actually, yeah, we're going to have to go outside and breed that Hawthorn, because we could fail making that whiff of magic and the whiff of purity. Oh, shut up. Do I have my sword? I hate mobs in my base. It's stupid. So I'm going to get everything ready to go, YouTube, and I will bring you back and we'll finish this up. Alright, YouTube, we're back and we're ready to proceed. So we've got our two whiffs of magic and our odor of purity here. We're going to throw our diamond into our mana pool. That'll give us back a mana diamond. We'll step over here to the crafting table. So the first thing we're going to knock out is this attune stone. So lava bucket, one of the whiffs of magic, and the mana diamond. That gets that done. And we'll go ahead and just, I don't think there's anything else to craft. There's not. All right. So this goes here. We're going to need 3 mana steel. This is where the Arcane Alembic comes into play. We'll need our gold ingots. Those are bronze. I got to go back upstairs and get gold because I'm not smart. Whiff of magic. Odor of purity. Let's run upstairs real fast. Oh, that's awesome. There's creepers inside my base now. Unfreaking believable. This is really getting annoying. Okay, cleaned up the creeper's mess. I'm gonna have to figure out how things are being allowed to spawn inside my base because it makes no sense. There's no unlit areas in my base for things to spawn at any longer. Unless they've changed how certain blocks work, but I'll probably just have to do as Drago said and put up a chandelier. Anyways, we were missing two gold. Here there are the two gold. There's the distillery. And we can pop that down. And the distillery is going to be used for something we're working towards, which is impregnating leather. So to make impregnated leather, you need a diamond vapor, which comes from the distillery. You need four whiffs of magic, and you need four leather for each four impregnated leather. And that's going to allow us to advance in other areas. So that's it. We're done. We made some serious progress tonight on the magic side. We've gotten our feet in the water with Witchery. We've gotten some serious movement forward in Thaumcraft in terms of the machines that we can put together. We made some more advanced machines for Botania so that we can start doing the fun stuff. We've got our mana pools all set up and gathering plenty of quantities of mana. Not much more to say, guys. As always, if you liked it, like it. If you'd like to see more, like it. Hit that subscribe button. You guys be good to one another, and I will see you next time. Laters.